Of course, you have had a viral or bacterial infection before, and this led to a sore and swollen throat. Well, your tonsils often get swollen, as they are the body's first line of immune defense against germs and bacteria. Tonsils filter bacteria and viruses that enter your body through your mouth. Did you know that the tonsils can form stones inside them and thus lead to your symptoms such as bad breath or sore throat? They are also called tonsillates. Hello everyone, today's video will be about tonsil stones. Hi, I'm Umeh from Plot Hospital, and in the next 6 minutes, I'm going to talk to you about tonsil stones, how they form, their symptoms, and how they can be diagnosed and treated. And before we start, please subscribe to our channel so the next time you'll be updated with our new releases. First, what are the tonsils? The tonsils are a pair of small oval-shaped bits of tissues at the back of your throat. Inside the tissue of the tonsils, there are some cells designed to protect against infections, known as lymphocytes, which makes a tonsil part of the lymphatic system. So what exactly is tonsil stone? Tonsil stones are hard and painful yellowish material that appear on or inside the tonsils. You may have one tonsil stones or many tonsil stones. They're usually small, though sometimes people can get large tonsil stones. Tonsil stones are more common in youngest than in adults, which range in size from noticeable to pea-sized. So how tonsil stone is formed? Food, dead cells, and bacteria may all become lodged in the tonsils' nooks and crannies. Because they are seen as foreign pathogens by the body's immune system, white blood cells are sent to the region to combat infection. When white blood cells die, they leave behind small calcification. Normally, these tiny stones are swallowed, but occasionally they become lodged in the tonsillar crypts and develop into tonsil stones. Now let's talk about the symptoms of tonsil stones. Some tonsil stones don't cause any symptoms, but they can cause a lot of trouble to you. Bad breath or halitosis is one of the main signs of tonsil stones. Other symptoms can include cough, earache, sore throat, bad taste in your mouth, tonsil swelling, or throat infections that are hard to treat with antibiotics. Now, you may ask how tonsil stone is diagnosed. Now, diagnosing a tonsil stone very much depends on the size and location of this calcified buildup. Typically, the diagnosis for tonsillitis is usually based on a physical exam. If you don't have any symptoms, your doctor might notice a stone during a scan or x-ray for a different problem, or your dentist may see them during a dental exam. In addition to the physical exam, your doctor may want to run some tests in order to determine the cause of the infection. The two most common tests are the throat swab, which checks for the infection with the group A streptococcus, and blood tests, which are typically used to diagnose mononucleus. You may ask if there is a home remedy for tonsil stone. In most cases, tonsil stones can be managed at home. There are some remedies and medical procedures that help remove tonsil stones, like gargling intensely with salty, warm water that can help with the pain and removing bad odor. Also, coughing continuously. Coughing can also help with loosening tonsil stones stuck in the throat. Eliminate smoking and other tobacco products from your diet. Brush your teeth regularly. And if gargling and coughing don't dislodge the stone, it's tempting to use your finger or a toothbrush to get rid of tonsil stones. Before we finish, let us discuss how this illness can be prevented. So there are some things you can do in order to prevent the formation of tonsil stones, such as 1. Maintaining good and healthy oral hygiene. When you keep your mouth clean and removing food particles can play an important role in preventing tonsil stones from flourishing by reducing the amount of materials and bacteria in your mouth that can contribute to tonsil stone growth. Now, don't smoke or quit smoking if it's the case. Finally, stay hydrated by drinking plenty of water. Thank you for joining us in yet another video covering key health-related topics with Plot Hospital TV. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll respond to you as soon as possible.